In this video, we're going to dig into each of the custom fields. So if you've found that the Shopify fields or standard fields don't have what you want, not a problem, you can create it with custom fields. Now, this is going to be a longer video, but we'll cover a lot of ground on how you can use each of these fields. And we've also created video chapters for each custom field, so you can jump ahead to a certain one. Let's get started. Single line text fields allow customers to respond using a few words. This is great for asking customers questions that only need a short response. And while we're here and looking at this first custom field, let's also take a look at the field settings. Each field may have unique settings along with some standard ones like field label, data column, placeholder text, requiring validation, and so on. The multi-line text field provides a text box that's suitable for lengthier responses from your customer. You can use this field for more open-ended questions like customer feedback or a bio. The number field allows customers to enter a number in either integers or decimals, depending on which setting you select. For example, we could ask, how many times have you shopped with us before? And then set this to integer, which will only allow whole numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4. Or we could ask, how tall are you? Then you'd select decimal here in the settings, and now customers could say that they're 5'5" or 7'9". Another setting to note for number fields is step. If you raise or lower this, your customers will see small arrows on this field that they can click to increase or decrease the number. If you select, let's say, 3, then the value will go up by 3 instead of 1 each time. You can also get crazy and make your own step value, like 3.14, and customer fields will calculate those increases as well. You can create a list of options in a drop-down format for customers to choose from using the drop-down field. If you have a lot of options, this is a neat and tidy way to store those options. So I'll create a drop-down field that asks the customer what their favorite social media platform is. Now we look at the field settings panel and can add values for the drop-down. With value lists like this, you can also click on these two lines here and drag the values to reorder them. And a quick pro tip, if you want to add a lot of options without having to type them in manually, you can click these three dots, select Import CSV, and import a list of field options in bulk. Similar to the drop-down field, we can use drop-down with search to display a large number of fields, and this time with an added search bar. With this field, you can bulk import up to 500 field options via CSV. In addition, the drop-down with search field also includes a powerful feature that allows you to populate field options using a Google Sheet, which is great for cases where you have more than 500 options for a single field. Find the link in this video's description if you want to set that up. The drop-down with search field also includes some handy settings to control the search logic, along with a customizable message for no search matches. Radio choices are ideal when you only have a couple of options that you need the customer to choose one from, or if you just need to make a yes or no type field. I can create a simple select your preferred t-shirt size, then add values for the various sizes. When we preview this field, we can see that if you select a second option, the first one is deselected. The single checkbox field is perfect for things like agreeing to terms and conditions. One helpful setting here to note is you can choose to have this box checked by default. The multi-choice list field is great if you want your customers to select multiple options in cases where more than one value might apply. Each option will show up as individual checkboxes that the customer can select. I'm going to fill in the description for this field. It can be really useful to use the description tool for fields like this to make sure that the customer knows that they can select multiple choices. So I'm going to write select all that apply. You can select a specific date from your customers by adding a date field. We love using this field to ask for a person's birthday. That way we can use other tools like an email marketing app to send them a happy birthday message. You can pick from two formats, a calendar-like date picker or a drop-down field. You can also customize the year range as needed, as it may make more sense to have a smaller or larger year range depending on the information you want to collect. The file upload field is exactly that. It allows a customer to upload a file, a photo, or a document. This is very useful for things like collecting wholesale permits or a resume. In this example, we're simply asking customers to upload a photo of their dog for their account. And there are several built-in error messages that appear if the file size is too large, like over 25 megabytes, if the file doesn't have a valid file extension, or if the file is an executable file, like a program or a script. We block these for security reasons. You might be wondering why we have another email address field under custom input fields. We built it so you can collect one or more additional email addresses from your customers without it changing or affecting their Shopify account email. Our email address field also has a validation rule in place to make sure the customers can only input valid emails. And similar to the email address field, our phone number field is meant to collect additional phone numbers from your customers without changing or updating the main phone number that they already have on their Shopify account. This field also has a validation rule in place so that only valid phone numbers can be entered by your customers. The group field is a super handy tool to bundle fields together on your form. And it's particularly useful if you have several fields that you want to keep together so that you can use custom CSS or create a form rule around them. In our next video covering rules, we'll discuss showing or hiding a group field based on a customer's response to a different question. And repeating groups help you collect multiple sets of related data from customers, like multiple pets, students, businesses. And there are some helpful settings in here too. So I'll create a repeating group field using some of our other custom fields we've made so we can take a look at this together. For settings, we can rename the add item, delete item, and the heading content. So for our social media profile repeating group, I'll say add account, remove account, and account count of total. So that's it, all 14 custom input fields. And if you want to learn more or if you get snagged along the way, check out our help docs or reach out to our support team. They are the nicest people you'll ever meet. In our next video, we'll add an additional layer of power and flexibility using form rules. I'll see you there.